Hey, this is Chris Summers with the Summers team, KW Philadelphia, Fishtown. Last week we talked about 19125, the state of the market. Today, it's Market Monday. We're talking about Port Richmond. Port Richmond is hot. It's been hot. Years ago, we wrote on our blog, what is the next hot up-and-coming neighborhood? It was Port Richmond, and we specified why. That blog got tons of shares, tons of views, and it still does. And the reasons then is the same as today. Why? Awesome community, strong community feel. And with the wave of what's happened recently from Northern Liberties to Fishtown to East Kensington to Port Richmond, as people got priced out of these other neighborhoods, they went to Port Richmond. As tenants got priced out from these other neighborhoods, they went to Port Richmond. Furthermore, a lot of people might be familiar with the new construction project we've been marketing and selling, Kensington Courts at Frankfort and Lehigh. That has basically taken the Lehigh barrier or boundary and just crushed it. Yeah, so there's tons of stuff happening north of Lehigh, which is more Richmond or Harrogate or Kensington. North of Lehigh, from Frankfort to Aramingo, you can call it lots of different things, but tons of investors are looking in there. The artists have moved there. And one school of thought over the years, which is why we bought Northern Liberties back in 2004 and then started investing in South Kensington and in Fishtown, is go where the artists are. Wherever the artists go, good things happen. Cafes, restaurants, art galleries, so forth. It just becomes a great neighborhood. So today we're going to talk about Port Richmond. I got some stats and I got my crystal balls. If you remember, I got my money ball and the important sixer ball. Trust the process, trust real estate. On the investing side, the last few properties that we purchased personally, buy and hold, have been in Port Richmond. On the developer side, there's not a lot of vacant lots left in Port Richmond, but there is a project on Belgrade. It's just kind of right at the border, but it's still Port Richmond. They're pending around $500,000 right now, and there continues to be more restaurants opening up, on Lehigh, which is Fishtown, but on Somerset, and then the Richmond corridor. Guarantee you 2 or 3 years from now, or maybe a year from now, might be a vast difference than it is today. So I would encourage homeowners, investors, the Port Richmond neighborhood, you can get a really nice home in the $250,000 to $300,000 range. You can get a nice, really nice home in the $200,000 to $250,000 range. And investors kind of looking below that, getting some sweat equity. The tenant demand, is very strong. And you do have a high percentage of homeowner occupancy. Long story short, read our blog, why Port Richmond is the next hot area. And then now let's look at some statistics in terms of what's happened in Port Richmond since the lights went off or since the shelter in place, and maybe, kind of what our prediction is moving forward. So how many new properties have come on the market in Port Richmond? And we're just looking between Aramingo in Richmond from Somerset up to Castor for basically just the Port Richmond area right now. The 19134 zip code encompasses a lot of places, so you really kind of have to know what you're looking at. New listings, nine. Nine new listings in Port Richmond in the last 30 days. Coming soon, two, if you could see that, two. Both of these coming soon listings are our office, by the way. Of the nine new listings, four are from our office. Active under contract, two. One of these is my own personal property. We're buying some, but I'm going to sell one too. Uncle Sam needs a little jingo. Port Richmond pending. You can see that, two. Two properties have gone pending in the last 30 days. Now, some people, similar to 19125, these could be coming back on the market 17 properties are temporarily off the market. What could be happening here? Maybe it's tenant occupied, owner occupied, really hard or really can't do showings, or maybe they're just going to punt that listing decision to next year. Same with withdrawn. Withdrawn, there's 15 properties that have been withdrawn, since the shutdown. So perhaps these come back on the market a little bit later, perhaps not. Or they contact the Summers team, to get it sold. Speaking of sold properties, there are 16, that have settled, since the lights went off per se. Five of which, was KW Philadelphia. Some of that five, is obviously, our office. So what does that mean? There's not too many more new listings, when you look at the overall cheat sheet, about 11 when you add the active and coming soon versus properties that have gone under contract, active with contract or pending, four. So, and then there's been a lot of settlements, in the interim. So really, what's happening here? Well, A, the demand is still strong. B, inventory is not going up that much. And C, I can guarantee you when this is happening, there's this kind of arrow that's being pulled back of demand. People that want to lock into interest rates of 3, maybe 2.34 or 2.75, and so forth. So when the lights get turned back on here, where Governor Wolf kind of releases the shelter, in place for real estate, not since there's not too many new listings, there's still not a lot for a buyer to choose from. But the good news for a buyer, they'll have a little bit more to choose from, maybe a little bit more negotiation leverage, but at the same time, they're competing with other buyers that are going to be doing the same thing. We just put one of our, like I said, one of our own properties that we own under contract. But those folks saw it, before, the shelter in place came in the place. So they had already saw it. Virtual tours are still, important, obviously, for people to go under contract and maybe have longer inspection periods. But I get the question all the time, and that's why we're doing this. What's the state of the market? I saw a national economist, do a little Zoom webinar last week, kind of saying the exact same thing that I did. I felt better after he said it because I did mine first. So that was some nice reinforcement that sellers are planning on listing prices pretty much the same as before. And the buyer demand, most of those people that could have bought back then can still buy. Not everyone, has lost their job or still at 70% employment, depending on, what stats you're looking at. And for the people that were kind of furloughed, perhaps they get their job back. But the Port Richmond, the benefit here, is you have both homeowner demand and investor demand and the lifestyle. Like I mentioned at the beginning, tons of new business opening up, north of Lehigh. The Richmond corridor is going to be kicking in, the restaurants, the cafes. So you have some walkability. Plus, maybe you're not taking that Uber ride downtown, to go to an awesome restaurant. You're just taking a quick Uber ride to go to Fishtown, to go to Soraya, Mull Horrens. The list goes on and on. So basically, everything is still close to you. So, I got the money ball and I got the sixer ball. But basically, what am I saying here? If I'm Jim Cramer, I'm saying bye, bye, bye. Boom. Bye, bye, bye in Port Richmond. Obviously, opportunities, it will be there. If you're interested, someone else is going to be. Obviously, the only caveat here, God forbid, if the virus gets worse, all bets are off, but things do look like they're getting better. And if so, take advantage of Port Richmond as an owner occupant, take advantage as an investor, keep your eye out there. Maybe you go west to Aramingo too as an investor. Because the cash flow might be a little bit better there than east of Aramingo, but tons of opportunities. Thank you for tuning in this Monday and Market Monday. Next week, we'll have another neighborhood. If there's something specific you want, message us, here on Facebook, IG, Twitter, or whatnot. We'll be there for you. The Summers team, the Sixers. Boom. Signing off, baby. Boom.